weights for class today. So I have just a 3-pound and 5-pound dumbbell. So whatever you have, it can even just be body weight. But we're gonna get started. So welcome to Circuit Training. Happy Monday. Y'all, tomorrow is December 1st. What is going on? This is crazy. Terry's like, I'm ready. Okay, so here we go for our warm-up. This is gonna be a little more mobility based. We're gonna start with a hip hinge. You're gonna start with your hands actually together at prayer at your chest. Your feet are just under those hips. And you're going to hinge forward just about halfway, not all the way. And then it wants you to bend your knees and drop your hips into a squat. You're gonna push all the way back up and repeat. So hinge forward halfway, hamstrings and glutes, bend the knees, drop the hips for that squat and lift back up. So we're gonna hinge forward, we're gonna drop and up. So it doesn't matter how far, how low you go in that squat. Just listen to your body and your range of motion. Go ahead and turn on those core muscles right away. So we hinge forward about halfway, bend those knees, drop those hips. So let's do 4 more of these. I'm gonna turn on some music. So 4 more. I felt like some classic rock today. So we're gonna jam with it. All right? All right, let's do 1 more. Hip hinge, drop, and lift. Excellent, okay. So next one's for our upper body. You're gonna bring your knees together, hips down. We're gonna inhale, reach those arms up. Exhale down. So we're gonna do 10 of these. Like just making a snow angel. Keep your shoulders away from your ears though. So working those lats. So up and back. Let's do 5 more. Tuck those hips under, pull those abs in. 4. 3. 2 more. Last one. Alright, come on up. Full body. Make sure you're firm in front of you. Inch firm. Flat back first. Right? Bend your hands, meet the floor. Walk it out. Open up side plank. Reach to the other side. Lock your hands back up. Reach to the ceiling. And let's repeat. Walk it out. Open up side plank. Other side. Walk back up. Hands reach to the ceiling. Let's do 3 more of those. 3 more of those. And when you press up, I want you to think of piking your hips straight up to that ceiling. Linda knows we did that this morning in class, right? So that's all in the hips and the core. Pipe those hips up. We're gonna do 1 more. 1 more set. All right, you guys, you're gonna sit low. So come back down, hands and knees. Hip circles, tabletop. Right leg, circle. Making circles with your knee. Loosen up those hips. Keep your head up. Reverse direction. Two more. All right, other leg. Draw circles, big circles with your knee. Opening up those hips. All right, reverse your circles, reverse direction. All right, 1 more circle. All right, last work exercise, stay down. We're gonna do a hyperextension to a push-up. So you can go on your mat or on your carpet, whatever you're using here. Hyperextension, and then push-up. So I'm doing this on my knees, you can do them on your toes. All right, here we go. We're gonna do 5 of them. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, push all the way up to that plank. Let's lower down and repeat. Hyperextension and push up. Tuck those hips under. We're on number 3. Squeeze and lift. Warming up all those back muscles. Let's try 2 more here. Extension. Tuck and lift. And we're gonna try 1 more. So inhale, lift up. Exhale, last one, you're gonna hold your plank. So hands, forearms, knees, you're gonna hold it for 30 seconds. Whatever variation you are doing. It is the last day of Planksgiving. So this is the only plank we're doing in class. You're gonna hold it. Hold it, hold it. You're holding it for about 15 more seconds. This is just a warm up, all right? Keep going, make sure you're breathing. We'll stretch it out in just a few seconds. You've got 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, let's roll up to standing. Nice work. So circuit training, this workout is for everyone. So I will give you guys lots of different options for that high impact, that low impact. Let's go ahead and roll the shoulders. And if something is not working for you today, just type in the chat box and let me know. So full body roll, shoulders first, bend those knees as we inhale lower and exhale up. We are gonna use weights today if you have them. Let's do it again. So get those ready. If you don't have them, you'll just use your own body weight. And last one, let's stay nice and low here. So just kind of move side to side. And we'll twist here with the shoulder. Also be mindful of how you're feeling today. It is rainy, at least where I'm at. Let's roll it up. So I know for me, my joints tend to be a little more sensitive, a little more achy. So again, just take the workout to your own speed and intensity as always. But especially today, let's open up those hips here and we'll get started. So I've got a circuit of 4 exercises for you. I'm gonna demo the first 2 with those weights. I'm choosing lighter for this exercise. I'm gonna go through this quickly, talk a little bit more about it when we get into our work. Narrow squat and then lift up for a goalpost. So narrow squat, goalpost. But what you're doing is really squeezing those shoulder blades together. So down and lift, exercise 2, maybe heavier weights here, single leg deadlift. With that heel up, you stop right about there, and then a bicep curl as we lift our knee to our chest, okay? Exercise 3 is just gonna be doing the other side. You can also choose to do a deadlift with both feet on the ground. And then our last one, plank row, tricep extension. The arms look like this, row, tricep. So you can start standing and bent over. The extra challenge is, of course, in your plank, okay? Row and tricep. So much heavier weight right there. We're only doing 1 at a time. So let's get started, 45 seconds. Then I have a fun core exercise and AMRAP after the circuit. So we're gonna start with that narrow squat, goalpost squeeze, starting in 3, 2, and go. Let's start. So narrow squat. Which means your feet, your knees are close together. You are dropping those hips back as far as you can. And you open up, I want you to squeeze those shoulder blades together. Keep it up. So this is already low impact. Keep it up. Hold on to your energy. We got a lot more to go. A lot more to do. You have about 5 more seconds. We're gonna grab those heavier weights. Preview. This will be your next exercise. Deadlift. Okay? We'll work on that left leg. Go ahead and grab those heavier weights if you don't already have them. 45 seconds. We get a couple seconds transition. All right, left leg back. 3, 2, let's go. Tuck those hips under. It's deadlift. Knee to chest as you add your bicep curl. Keeping that back nice and flat. So I'm going to do it for the first couple seconds. You can watch my screen. Make sure you're mimicking my shape that I'm making here, my form. All right, keep moving. Let me see it now. You have about 15 more seconds. So we stay on this side. Then we'll switch. Perfect. Good, Blair. You guys look really nice. Go ahead and tuck those hips under, engage the core muscles right away. All right, we got about 5 more seconds. Oh, we got Mary Beth and Katie in the house, a Christmas tree in the house. I love it. All right, shake it out, just a few seconds. We're just switching sides. You're starting in 3, 2, tuck those hips under first, and then start. You guys see that difference there? Go. So remember that standing leg, slightly bent. Elbows in for that curl. Flex that back foot. Woo! Now, if balance is maybe a little too much for you today, you're just not feeling it, regular deadlift and curl. Just like that warm up. Let me see it. You should feel the back of your legs with the movement. Your glutes, your hamstrings, right? Deadlift is working all those back muscles. Our squats are gonna work the front part. We got about 5 more seconds. Then we've got the plank, row, and tricep extension. Standing, we're in that plank. 3, 2, all right, shake it out. Take that one heavy dumbbell. I'm gonna do this standing. Go ahead and do it in the plank for the extra challenge. Here we go, 3, 2, and go. It's one arm at a time. It's row and then tricep extension. Switch sides. Row, tricep extension. I want you to really pull that elbow up and back. And I want you to completely extend that arm straight out. Nice, Suzanne, for that tricep extension, yes? Awesome, perfect. So if you were in that bent over position, really be mindful of your core. Also in your plank too. But keep your neck nice and long, your back nice and flat. Either way. We got about 10 seconds left. We're gonna start back at the top, okay? And we'll do it 2 more times. Oh, I love a song. And don't let go. Keep it up. Classic rock kind of day. 3, 2, shake it out. We come back to exercise 1. Narrow squat, goal post. We start in 3, 2, tuck those hips under, go. Woo! Keep it up. So talk about the core, tucking the hips under. Did class this morning, wasn't paying attention to it. So now my lower back is kind of achy. So I wanna make sure that you guys are engaging those core muscles, okay? Keep going, so if your arch here, tuck under. You'll feel much better. 15 seconds. I was just a hot mess this morning, let's be honest. You guys look great. Remember, you're squeezing your shoulder blades together. We're almost there. 4, 3, 2, 1. Deadlift, 2 curl. I would suggest those heavier weights. It's that left leg back first. Tuck those hips under. Pull the shoulder blades back. Here we go. And start. It's deadlift. Nice strong core. Knee to chest as you curl. Woo! So maybe that extra challenge, what I'm doing here. Oh, except when I fall over. Try to keep your foot off the floor. So you go right into that deadlift, woo, right into that knee lift. Keep going, let's see it. Cling to tight. Excellent, nice, very good. Your body's like a chopstick. So nice and straight. Perfect, keep that head up. Everyone looks really good. It is all ladies today. All right, you've got 3, 2, shake it out. We got a few seconds in between, other side. Here we go, tuck those hips under. Shoulders back, let's go. Right leg. Woo, you go. So these first 2 circuits, mainly strength based. We'll get some core and cardio, don't you worry. Nice flat back, woo! Alternative, deadlift, both feet on the floor, right? Little extra support for your back. So just listen to your body. Woo, that plank row, tricep extension. That is coming up next. You've got 3, 2, 1, shake it out. Grab that one heavy weight. Here we go, row and extension. Starting in 3, 2, let's go. And your plank. Or bent over, standing, right? We can do stagger stance. One arm at a time, so we work the core too, okay? So I'm doing that staggered stance. Maybe you're holding onto two dumbbells. If you want them heavier, another little option there. So I've got my three and my five since I don't have an 8 pound, right? Ooh, yeah, that definitely makes it harder. Keep going, keep going. We have a couple seconds left. We're gonna do one more round. It's gonna be a little bit shorter. You've got 3, 2, 1. Okay, back to our first exercise. Here we go, narrow squat with that goalpost squeeze. Go. Let's go. So maybe you got a little bit lower. Maybe a little lower, maybe you have a little bit heavier weights. Nice Mary Beth, good form. Elbows, they're where? They're at shoulder height, right? Tuck those hips under. Make sure we're not arching that back as we squeeze. Woo! Keep it up, this one's a little bit shorter. You've got 4, 3, 2, deadlift and curl. Ready, set, go. Left leg back. Woo! Keep it up. Good time. Try to keep that foot off the floor. Try that little extra balance. Nice kitty. Yep, you go right into that deadlift. Right into that knee. Woo! And switch sides. Ready, set, go. Switch sides. Tuck those hips under. Hello, hamstrings. And glutes. I want you to squeeze those glutes, right? You all are like perfect. Everyone looks really good. Keep it up. Our core is coming up after that plank row. I've got 2 maybe not so fun exercises coming up. You've got 3, but we're gonna do them. 2, 1, plank row. Row and tricep. Last time. Ready, set, go. So I'm gonna do both arms for this final round. I'm gonna stand, staggered stance, both. It's only 30 seconds. Maybe grab both of those smaller dumbbells. Keep it up. If you're in that plank, can you bring your feet a little closer together and narrow that stance? Maybe make it a little harder. Nice, Linda. Good. Keep those shoulders nice and square. Shoulders and hips are squared off. Let's go. Tuck those hips under. You've got 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. So we're coming down onto the floor. We have a hollow hold. For 1 minute, this is your hollow hold. You're here. You can hold weights if you want. You can bend the knees to shorten it, a little bit more support on your back, but the straighter and lower your legs are, the less support on your back. 1 minute hollow hold, okay? Here we go, come on down. Keep that heart rate up. Ready, set, and go. Hollow hold, you're just gonna hold it. Arms overhead, legs straight out, head is up. Press that back into the floor. Woo, you should feel a shake. So maybe you're on that tabletop. I'm gonna show that tabletop option. If you wanna follow along with me. Maybe you hold those dumbbells overhead, a little harder for those abs, keep it up. We're halfway there, 30 seconds, so we're gonna stand right up. Let me see the hollow hold. Most important part is that low back pressing into the mat, okay? Wherever you are at, I should not be able to slide my hand under your hips or under your back. Make sure you're breathing. Keep it up, keep it up. We have an AMRAP cardio coming up. You got less than 10 seconds. You're gonna stand right back up. This one you might hate, but that's okay. Because we're gonna do it together. 3, 2, stand up. All right, it's AMRAP, burpee time. So, you guys know the burpees, modification. You can step it out, come back up. But I wanna make sure that you're leading with your hips. So we're not down like this. So remember, come down with your hips, step or jump out, come back up. Other option. Okay? So you're not even coming to the floor. How many can you get in 1 minute? Ready? Go. 1 minute, go. So I'm stepping it back if you want to follow me. But I'm reaching up onto my toes, reaching up to the ceiling. Keep it up. Maybe you had that tuck jump. Maybe you had a push up. You got to count. Less than 30 seconds. Keep counting. Woo, you got this. Chat box, remember in your head, water. Water break. Whew, how we doing? Thumbs up? Awesome. Awesome. Okay, so now we're going to move on to circuit number two. Similar format, different exercises. So you get a little bit of a breather here. Of course, keep moving or stretch it out. All right, so here's what we're doing. Oh, yeah, sumo squat. Remember, back to that strength focus. Open up from your hips. Sumo squat. Front raise, then we're gonna pull the weights back, drop them back down. Sumo, lift, pull. So again, nice fun combo movements to switch it up for you. Extra challenge, lift up to your toes, lower. Okay, exercise two is a weighted donkey kick. This one is really good for glutes and hamstrings. I would suggest lowering to your forearms. Lift, okay? You want to try and get the knee higher than your hip. Stomp up to the ceiling. Exercise three to switch sides. Exercise four, and then we'll start. Roll up and punch. Heavy weights. Sit up. Punch, punch, diagonal. Back down as soon as you lower. And I want to see head up, chest up. So let's start with our sumo squat. Down, lift, pull back. 45 seconds. Little bar move, ready, set, go, and go. Straight up, pull back, back down. So I would suggest lightweight to start. You can always make it heavier and add if you need to. Extra challenge, you lift up to your toes and you hold there as you pull back, right? Keep going. I want that part to also be slow, so we're not just scooping it. Make sure the movement's coming from your shoulders. Okay? Pause for a second, and then pull back. Pause, pull, drop. Woo, keep it up. Couple more seconds, donkey kick. 3, 2, come on down. Heavy weight behind that right knee. On your hands, or I suggest forearms. Ready, set, go. Press up and down. Keep it up. So I didn't say, if you want the extra challenge, you can do this in a bear pose. So you would have to be on your hands. That means your other knee is lifted off the floor. So that's a lot more challenging. I'm gonna do a couple reps if you want to take a quick look at my screen and see how that looks. So I'm doing that bear. Woo! So a lot harder, keep it up for everything, your core, your upper body, everything. Just an extra challenge there. We're gonna switch sides in 3, 2, all right, couple seconds, switch sides. I'll show that bear one more time on this side if you wanna try it. Ready, set. And go. So I'm doing that bear. My other knee is lifted off the floor. Woo! So join me for that extra challenge. If not, other knee is on the floor, back to the regular movement, okay? Keep it up. You wanna drop that knee just a couple inches And as you exhale, you want to press it all the way up. Our roll up and punch is coming up next. It's that sit up. Weighted sit up with the punches. Perfect. Can we stomp our foot up to the ceiling? A little bit harder. We're almost there. You've got 3, 2, and 1. Flip on over to your back. Couple seconds transition. Heavy weights here. Oh, make it mine. Roll up and punch. We're starting in 3, 2, let's go. Heels into the floor, lift up, punch, punch. Roll that down. Keep that chest up. Knees are bent here, heels into the floor. A little extra challenge, legs straight. Pull your heels into the floor. I'm not talking to you, Alexa. Woo, she always thinks I'm talking to her. Woo, this is hard for those abs with the heavy weight. Can you guys try it for 10 more seconds? Make sure you're pulling your abs as you roll down. Think Pilates. Right, as soon as your back touches the floor, roll back up. 3, 2, 1, that's that sumo squat. Come on up. Round two, here it is. Sumo squat with that front raise. Ready, set, go. So down, lift, hold it for a second, pull back. Sumo, maybe up onto your tippy toes. Shoulder height. Maybe this time you're trying those heavier weights. Really, it's up to you, okay? Woo! Keep moving. If you're in a sumo, make sure we're not pushing out like this. But tuck those hips under. Keep that back flat. If you're having a hard time, just bring your feet in a little bit. Your hips are tight. So out wide, maybe a little closer in. Woo! Can you get a little lower? Keep it up. You've got 4, 3, 2, donkey kick. Here we go. Heavy weight behind that right knee. We are starting in 3, 2, go. So the key here is keeping that flat back. Again, I suggest on your forearms to really just focus on those glutes. Unless you're doing the bear pose challenge. Woo! Keep your head up. Stomp that foot up to the ceiling. Let's go, let's go. Let me take a look. About 15 more seconds on this side, okay? Nice, good kitty, yep. Okay, I can't really see anyone. I see some of your feet, but make sure your back is nice and flat, right? Tuck those hips under. A couple more seconds on this side. All right, and stop. You're going to switch sides. Take a few more seconds. Behind that left knee. Here we go. Ready, set, and start. On those forearms. Or you're in your bear pose holds. So if that's the case, you'll probably be on your hands. Keep that back flat. Woo! Lift it up, lift it up. Woo! So we're gonna feel that stationary leg as well, right? Hold it. Push it up. Hold that position, guys. Just move the leg. Up and down, less than 15. Woo! Feel that booty. Flex that heel. Can you lift your knee up a little bit higher? We've got 3 more seconds. Woo, I'm feeling it. And then release. All right, our sit up with that punch. Okay, but it's a nice roll back and roll up. Here we go. Starting in 3, 2, and let's go. Heavy weights if you can. Lift up, punch. It's a diagonal punch across the body. Add that twist. Woo! Oh man, I'm feeling this. I'm feeling those abs. I don't know about you guys. Woo! One more time, a little more challenge. A little more challenging is legs straight out. Just be mindful of that back. There we go, looking good. You got less than 10 seconds. And then our final round, it'll be a little shorter. All right, and stand up. Sumo squat. Here we go, let's try those heavier weights. Starting in 3, 2, go. So I got my heavier weights, straight up. Lift up to your toes, balls in your feet. Woo, a little bit harder. Oh my goodness. Remember, I want you to pause. Hold that straight out for a second, keep it up. Let's see it. Nice, very good, Mary Beth. Oh, I like the plates. Perfect. Good, good, good. Straight up. Reach it across. Couple more seconds. 3, 2, donkey kicks. Let's go. Come on down. Try the bear pose if you haven't tried it yet. Maybe just for 2 reps. Ready, set. Behind the right knee. And go. Sorry, my sister's texting me. Let me turn off that notification. Keep it up, keep it up. Do, do. Try that bear, right? So that knee is right underneath the hip. Lift it off the floor. Try a couple sets for a couple reps. Less than 10. Ooh, yeah, much harder with that knee floating off the floor. You've got 3. Head up 2. Other side. Other side, other side. We start in 3, 2. Let's go. Try the bear if you haven't tried it. Just once, just try it once, right? Woo! Can you lift up a little higher? I'm trying the bear here. Woo! Oh yeah, much harder. So just try it a couple times and then lower that forearm. Right? Okay. Squeeze to lift, come on. Woo! 5 seconds, ladies, let's do it. All right, sit up and punch. Hold on to those weights. Here we go, last time, 30 seconds. 3, 2, go. Woo. Punch, punch. Maybe speed it up a little bit. Just a little bit. Tiny bit faster, can you do that? Woo. Chin up, head up, come on. Pull those abs in as you lower, let's go. 5 seconds, and we're about to hollow hold. All right, hollow hold, 1 minute. Ready, set, go. Last time, hollow hold. Hollow hold, whatever version you're doing, right? Maybe it's the tabletop, hands behind the head, okay? Most support, can look at my screen, match me. A 1 minute has started. Maybe you're using weights overhead this time. You're already 20 seconds in, come on. 1 minute. Press that back into the floor. Woo! I'm shaking. Push the back into the floor. Oh my goodness. Keep it up, keep it up. Remember, the lower your legs are, the less support for your back. Keep that in mind. But we're gonna have a good time. Don't stop me now. Having a good time. Hold it, hold it. Hold it. And stop. Come on up slowly. Guess what's next? 1 minute AMRAP burpees. Remember your number. Your goal is to beat it. All right? Ready, set, ready, set. Go. Try to beat it. Keep up, keep up. Don't stop me now. Come on. Halfway. Are you gonna make it? I know you can. Keep up. 10 seconds. Go. No, you can stop. Woo! Okay, water. Almost done. So we have four exercises left. Okay? We're gonna do them all out, 1 minute each. That's what we're gonna finish with. Just looking for my other weight. They're all weighted if you want them to be. Here's what we're doing. Weighted skaters, all out. 1 minute with the hop, without the hop. Then we have lunge and twist. All right? So we'll switch that halfway. Then we've got M's and T's with the arms, making letter M, making letter T. And then our last one is gonna be a broad jump forward. Tap the floor, arms up as you shuffle back. Broad jump, tap, shuffle. Of course, you take out the jump. This is it. 1 minute, one time through. Start with skaters. All right? Ready, set, go. So I'm doing no weight here. It's up to you. Woo, come on. Last 4 minutes of class. You can do this. Add those arms if you can. Keep it up, keep it up. Add that hop. Keep it up. You got 20 seconds. Are you adding that hop? Right on that jump? She's skating away. I see you. Okay, Mary Beth. Can you get a little lower? Woo! Yes. Keep moving. And lunge and twist. Right leg. Go. Step back. Twist. Step back. Right leg. Woo! Lunge. Twist. Keep it up. I'll let you know when we're halfway. We'll switch sides. That's a great song. Keep that chest up. Switch sides. Left leg. Go. Keep it up. It's inhale, step back. Exhale, twist. Preview of exercise three. Keep moving. M's, T's. We're doing it bent over. I would suggest lightweight, but maybe heavy. We are doing it once. All right, ready, set. M's and T's, tuck those hips under. Go. Straight back, side. Straight back, side. M, T. Maybe a staggered stance. Feels better. Arms are stick straight, okay? You're gonna feel your back here. Your upper back means nice, good flare. You're halfway if you wanna do heavier. 30 seconds, maybe switch that leg. Come on, head up. Woo! Keep moving, preview of our last one. It's gonna be that broad jump tap. Pedal back, okay? I'm gonna be stepping forward instead of jumping. You've got 7 seconds and then your final minute of work. We're gonna add those weights to that broad jump. 3, 2, go. Broad jump or 2 big steps. Touch the floor, pedal back. Broad jump, tap, pedal. Right? Big jump, tap the floor. Big jump, tap the floor. Keep moving, keep moving. Woo, you got less than 30 seconds. Keep it up, keep it up. Woo. Keep it up. When you jump, push back onto your heels, right? Not straight on those knees. 5 seconds. 3, 2, One. Oh my goodness. Woo! Water. Oh my goodness. How are we doing? We still there? Thumbs up? Okay. We can't go yet. We got to stretch. Grab a quick drink of water. We got about 4 minutes left. Woo, you ladies were awesome. Awesome, awesome job today. All right. So let's cool it down. I'm just doing a nice little step touch here. So we're still moving a little bit. But it's nice and easy. We're going to roll the shoulders. Woo. So big deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth. Big shoulder rolls here. And slow it down even more. Feet out. Crisscross those arms in front. Shake it out. Woo! Awesome, awesome job. Stay right here. Take that right arm, reach it over. And then back to center. Inhale, exhale to the other side. Big reach. And then we'll do it one more time each side. Soft knees here. Back to the center, inhale. Exhale, other side. Woo! All right, let's come down to the ground. Let's start on our back. So on our back, you're gonna hug those knees into your chest. Hug those knees into your chest. If your heart rate is still high, then take a few moments in a cat-cow. And then come down onto the floor. If you're ready, let's go ahead and just hug our knees into our chest and gently rock side to side, circling those ankles, wiggling our toes inside of our shoes, if we're wearing shoes. Let's make circles, massaging that low back, oh, that feels so good. Switch directions here. And then release. Let's extend that right leg up for a hamstring stretch. First, start with your other foot on the floor and that knee bent, straight leg. Then if you have the flexibility, range of motion, you can straighten that other leg and stretch it out onto the floor. One more deep breath. And let's bring that ankle across our knee for our figure four stretch. You can gently press against that knee or pull your legs closer into your chest. Hip and glute stretch. Woo! Boom, boom, boom. All right, let's switch. Other leg up. Remember, start with that other leg bent. Foot on the floor, and then left leg is straight up. For that hamstring stretch, then if you like, you can extend your leg, but just keep that low back supported on the mat. Right, shoulders down, head down, ankle over that knee. Same thing on this side. Woo! And then release, let's extend those legs out, arms overhead. Make ourselves a little bit longer here, nice big stretch. Big inhale and exhale. All right, slowly make your way over to one side. All right, let's come up to a tabletop. Usually start with this one, but switching things up a little bit. Nice tabletop. And then you're gonna bring your knees nice and wide, feet flat, toes down, sit way back into that nice child's pose. Forehead to the mat. And then slowly walk those hands up. Woo. Okay, let's find a downward facing dog. You're gonna tuck your toes, lift up and back. Pedal up those heels, press your chest towards your thighs, relax the head. Knees to the floor, roll up to standing. We'll do a quad stretch up there. So nice and slow, roll it up. Nice and slow. Shake it out. So find a spot against the wall or challenge yourself to do the balance here. We'll grab our right foot. I'll show from the side. Right foot, knees together. Remember to push those hips out and away. So nice straight line. Left arm up for balance, hold it here. And then release. Other side, we're holding onto that wall. or a dog cage, dog crate, whatever you got, right? So left foot, nice and straight here, knees together, push those hips out, press your foot into that hand, chest up, and release. All right, shake it out. Okay, inhale, lift up. Exhale, shake it out. One last time together. Inhale up and exhale it all out. And you are done. Awesome. Great work.
Thank you, Alan.
You're so